Hello everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel, Art Classes My Way. This video is being brought to us by Teresa Rowley. I do hope I am saying your name correctly there. Who is wanting to do, she sent me a couple of pictures through Instagram of things that she would like to learn how to do, because she is just not seeing, by looking at the pieces, she just can't tell how it is that people are making these pieces. So I've come up with a little class on, we're going to do a simpler one that can should show you all the techniques of where to go to make more complex ones, and maybe I'll even make a more complex one in the future, but especially for her, I'm just gonna do this one for now because of life, and I'm sure you all know how that goes. I work part-time at one job, part-time at another job, and one job, this is the busy season. It's a miniature horse farm where a lot of babies are being born this time of year. And then as soon as the busy season for that job's over, then my other job, being in retail, guess what? From fall to Christmas, it's chaos. So I really get like a very small period of relaxation in between absolute madness. But anyway, that's not your problem. You're here to learn. So just trying to justify why things may not come out when you hope they will. So I have a foot and a half of wire here. I have five base wires to begin with. I have a crystal I have managed to get a hold of that we're going to use for our focal stone. He is not pre-drilled anywhere. He is just raw. And I'll show you how to fix him inside of this little design we got going. Now, if any of you happen to know, by the time we get done with this piece, what this particular style of wire weaving is, I don't think anybody's really coined a term for it. But it's pretty complex wire weaving in itself. Lot of layers, lot of adding. And the thing is with this kind of wire weaving, why nobody ever shows you the backs of these pieces is because the backs look god awful. And I mean terrible. It looks beautiful and gorgeous on the front, but it is just a mess of knotted tangled wire on the back. And one, that's how you learn. You have to see the back in front of a piece in order to be able to figure out how it's all put together. But they'll never show you that part because nobody would pay the money that they ask for if they saw what the back of the piece looked like. So, but then again, you know, for pendants and things like that, which is what this particular method's used most for, it's not that big of a deal. So, alright, this is a ring mandrel, and you can order these guys online. I've never found them at Lowe's or Menards or Home Depot. I think somebody told me that they do carry something like this, but I ordered mine off of Amazon, and I'll include in a link below. Full disclosure, I do get a little bit of something back if you buy something off of Amazon through my little link. Down there, so you know, I don't know how much or anything, but I just want you to know. And he's pretty nice, especially to get a hold of pieces like this, but eventually he's not going to be very useful anymore. So I have myself a red wire. This is all, I've lost the label now. I'm going to put it at about 20 gauge. If not 20, then it's probably 18 gauge wire. It is silver coat copper. Again, nickel free. And then the weaving wire I am using, which I will regret, 28 gauge. And this is permanently colored, colored red. Or honestly, I call this more of a wine. I'm even probably going to use a little bit of the as well to get some more fun, or I might change my mind and change it to a brass wire. So fun there. And I'm going to go ahead and give myself a few good wraps. And I already hear the bad cat's up to no good. Cat doesn't even finish his own food, and he's trying to get into Sammy's food, which is in a little tote. Because he's a pudge. Let me see, get back to my sketches. I did, haha. This will teach me to put sketches on my damn computer. Nope, wrong one. There we go. Away with you. Alright. So I got wrap of three whole ones just to themselves. Fourth wrap, and then we're gonna go into the pattern itself. I'm gonna go one over the top of these guys. And then I'm gonna wrap over here. And whoop. Last track. I still lost track. All right. One, two. Do a completely different design than what I have drawn, because I don't know if that's even possible. The decision-making process and action. And I like to show you guys these kinds of things, even though it makes me look like an idiot. It just to show you that not everything always goes as planned, and sometimes you do have to think and change things on the fly. It's just a part of life. So, I'm going to go ahead and do one. And then I'm going to do one less. Kind of get a stair-steppy effect. I'm going to come over to the other side. Through the back, coming through the back part. This is one whole long one. One, two. Give myself two little wraps. And then there. Just doing the stair step effect again. Come up through the back, start back over on this side, the starting side. So, again, two wraps, one, two. Well, when you start, it's going to be 3 to 4 wraps. Always start things off with 3 minimum wraps. And then I just go across almost to the top. I leave out the last wire. And then I stair step it back. Then I take the wire underneath. And I do the same thing, just in reverse, going this way. So, I'm going to go ahead and weave a good chunk of this guy. I'm probably going to go probably about there. So let's say that's probably about 2, maybe 3 inches of this. And we got nice loose wires that I can do other things with and change up the pattern if I want. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. See you soon.
Thank you.
So I am going to go ahead and change one of my colors here from a red to a green. It's also, actually this one's 30, so it's going to take me even longer. And I'm going to do a different weave for this one as well. Since I'm going ahead and changing the color, might as well change the style of the weave. Have some fun. And I have taken, out of the five wires, it went one, two. I went ahead and bent this guy backwards because I can do some stuff with him in the back. Now I've crisscrossed this guy over. I don't know if I'm going to leave him crisscrossed necessarily. I might just do a different kind of weave going through. I'll worry about that when I get to it. And then, actually, you know what would be better than that? Let's think of this here. Let's do these two. Flip this guy backwards because the weave I'm going to do here is going to make it to where you won't notice that there's a missing wire. I'm sorry for the shaking. I'm trying to keep my arm in the same place every time, and it's kind of on a nerve, but I want to make sure I stay in camera. So the longer I stay this way, the more flippy I get. Also, I haven't eaten today yet, mostly because I've been... If any of you, as other artists, you probably all have done this. You get so into a project and you get in the groove of something that you do not want to stop no matter what. That's me today. So let's see here. One, two, three. Wraps around, beginning a new wire. And you can just continue with the old wire. That's entirely up to you. But once I get my third wrap around, I'm going to go around the other side. And it's going to be kind of like going around twice, but on the second one, we're going to come back this away. And this is going to give us this really cool web effect. And depending on how many times you weave in between going over to the next, jumping over to the next side, all determines the gap in between the webbing. So, yeah. I'm going to go ahead and pre-bend into the shape that I am wanting. And to get a nice natural curve, I'm just going to grab hold of the end here. And the wire is going to want to pretty much, unless something really funky has happened with the wire where it's work hardened in one specific spot more than in the other, this wire ought to just go ahead and bend pretty nicely the way you would want it to go. And got a little bit silly here. Just do it this way for now. And we'll grab hold of the end of this guy. Same. That'll work for the moment, and I will work on it a little bit better as I go. But I don't want to get it too wrapped all the way around, otherwise it is going to be a pain in the butt to try to weave it. Work on the uniformity there. And then just continue with your pattern. And since this is smaller in here, I'm going to just stick with the two wraps around. I'm probably going to have to do with more up here in order to keep this completely covered and keep the silver from showing. So keep that in mind. I'm probably going to end up putting about, start off with double to begin with, and then work from that and just kind of tweak as I go along. And I can even see here that once I put my two in there, my two still wasn't enough. So now I gotta put three in between instead of the four. I'm going to go ahead and leave myself a good length of tail here because I'm not going to be done weaving on this end. I'm going to go ahead and try to start developing the top half a little bit more. So there will be more going on with this a little bit later, but I'm going to start to see how this stone is supposed to fit now. You can see these wires are like a back support. And pretty much this whole thing here is our foundation. It is basically one great big cage that we are making first before we start doing all the other pieces. It's a lot like the hair comb where we had the building blocks and we had the frame for the whole piece, and then from there, from there you just start building more pieces around the cage that you've already made. So, actually probably want to set him a little bit more like this. I want these guys to be on the outside because it looks a little bit more dynamic to me with the three on this side here. So that's why I'm building it like so. And pretty much probably the less attractive part of this whole piece is being put on the back side, and that's what's going to be held on to the most once we are done. So that's that bit. Okay, so what I wanted to do for this is what I'm viewing as the top. Oh yeah. And by the way, I ended up liking the back of this weave a lot better than the front, but I've already goofed, so. Oh well. Kind of, like I told you, kind of keep in mind what you're wanting to do. I just really wanted to get this video started, but that's okay. I'll use that for another one for another day because that looks pretty darn cool. Alright, so we got our five here. Our three body. And whoop. That's one of our three main ones here. I want him on the underside. Just kind of going off into oblivion for now. this way. You are going to kind of go this way. And by doing this repetitively, I am slowly shaping the wire in different places very lightly as I go. So that's what I'm doing when I'm doing this. I'm using my thumb to try to shape it, but you'll run into places where it doesn't want to shape as easily. So you're just running over that same shape over and over again to make it all nice and uniform. All right, now. Now, I'm gonna have a weave that I'm gonna do for these two. But this wire is what's going to end up coming around the back and holding this guy in, along with these two wires. But we gotta do something frilly and decorative with him. So first, since I got these two wires shaped, and again, these are the three center wires, and I've taken the middle one and run him along the back. This is the sidemost wire. We're not doing anything with this guy at the moment. This is the tail to my red wire. I am going to start wrapping inside of that. So it's going to be kind of like red wire, green wire, red wire, green wire. And I'm sorry for it getting dark. I'll work on that in the editing section. It goes sunny, then it rains, then it's sunny, then it rains. But it's going red wire, green wire until I get to the green. So you've got a slight blend, just a little bit between them. And I'm going to go for the webbing idea again. This is a lot more subtle this go around. I'm going to do it one wrap, cross over, one wrap, cross back over, one wrap, cross over, one wrap, cross back over. These are very subtle fans right now as opposed to what we did down here. That's one around. Now the reason you want to put a wrap in between each one, it spaces them out a little bit better. I always find that a webbing looks better if there's at least one wrap in between each one. I don't know why, it just does. It keeps the wire straighter for some reason. And it's just an overall nicer look. You can just go back, forth if you want. It just never turns out very nice, and it always is way springier than what you really want to deal with. Where was I? Okay. That's the wrap around. This is going here. And while it seems like this can go really fast, and it can be done fast, but remember, the faster you go, the more problems that can happen, and the kind of the worse your weaving ends up looking. Kind of like every time I've ever taught somebody to draw and they just want to cheat with the shading and use the shader rather than taking their time when they were doing all their lines. You can always tell what takes more time and what's been pretty much gimped on. Okay, so the sense that's going to be the end of that wire there, since it snapped on me, I'm going to go ahead. Honestly, that looks like pretty much where I wanted to be with this. Anyway, I wanted to go just a little bit further, but you know, take what you can get. And now I'm just going, if yours didn't snap on you and you got your webbing where you want it to go, I'm just going to go ahead and wind the snot out of this wire. I'm pretty much going to cover the whole thing in this green wire. So have fun with that. All right, so I went ahead and continued wrapping this wire here, and I took my hopper. I came in here and I bent these two wires over. That's going to be the piece that our necklace is going to hang from. That's where the chain's going to slide through there. And I went ahead and finished this guy by wrapping him around here, and I might even unwrap a good chunk of him. I went a little overboard, and I'm going to run him along the side here with these guys, and then we'll see where we develop off to on that part of it. Now, as far as the crystal goes, I needed to do a little bit of adjustment to round this guy around, so he's holding on to the top, and he's over here pretty much providing pressure against this red part, and we'll be doing some more things with him to make him look a lot nicer, obviously. Now, as far as the bottom, I ended up having to bend this guy a little bit more, give him a little bit more of that crescent shape, and also pulling these guys around a little bit more so that way it is gripping the bottom half back part here, and they're going off, and we will be doing something with them and everything else as well a little bit later. So that's going to be the end of the video here. It may seem a little bit short to you guys, but this has so far been 3 hours worth of doing stuff, all condensed down into fast motion, obviously. So I do hope you guys are going to enjoy this. Please like, favorite, and subscribe. If you would like to donate to my channel, I do have a PayPal icon up on the top of my where my banner is, if you would like to do that. I very much appreciate it, and I hope you all have a wonderful day. Hopefully your day is going to be a little bit more stable than my day's been, because it was sunny and then it was going to rain again, sunny and rain again, since I started doing the wrapping part, and then me and my husband had dinner before he went to work. So the weather's just freaky right now. I guarantee you, because of how stupid the weather is being, one of the horses is going to have a baby tonight, and I got to stay up all night with them. Oh well. Baby horses, yay! I hope you all had a wonderful time, a wonderful day, a wonderful evening, wherever you are in the world, and thanks for coming and hanging out, everybody.